Get ready to match the stars. Bill Macy, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Elaine Joyce, Richard Dawson, thank you, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now, here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, one and all.
Oh, you're gorgeous.
I'm gorgeous.
How are you? Are you gorgeous?
I'm fine.
Good.
And I've just seen Beauty and the Beast.
Now, the southern plantation owner is...
No, Fernando Lamas.
Fernando Lamas, what is that?
Oh, I'm here to inspect the young coffee bean trees.
Oh, I see. We may have to inspect you before the day is over there. Shall we begin?
Sure.
All right, let's begin by saying hello to our two players, Roger Young and Terry Casey. Now, Roger's a current champ. He's won $600, right?
Right.
You feel good about that?
Feel great.
Good. And he's being challenged by Terry, who had a first-round question and did pretty well with it. Because, you know, they're tough, the first-rounders. And you did, too. Your first-round question is going to come along in a moment or so, but right now this message is going to come your way, so pay attention and then hurry right back, because we can't wait. All right. Now, we're ready to carry on. Middle of round one. Roger, this is your first-round question. Everybody plays.
Okay.
George has got this crazy idea that someone is following him. And he's so paranoid that he's installed rear-view mirrors everywhere, even on his blank. George thinks someone is following him.
Behind everywhere. Right. Where he goes, I see.
Do you understand that, Roger?
Yes, I do.
He thinks someone's following him, so he's installed rear-view mirrors everywhere, even on his blank.
Oh.
Should be easy for you.
Then why does that mean? What do you mean, why should it be?
I'll tell you later. Good. Good.
It's all right.
No, it's all right. You're the first one finished.
Yes, I am.
You're a goodie.
Even on his
blank. All right. All right, Roger Young. George has got this crazy idea that someone is following him, and he is so paranoid that he's installed rear view mirrors everywhere, even on his...
glasses.
Glasses is very good, Roger. That's the answer I would have said if I were playing. What'd you say, Bill?
Well, logic loses here. Tushy.
All right. Okay. Brett, what do you say?
How could you... I don't understand that.
You sound like... What's her name?
Marion Lorne. Lorne is... posterior portion.
Yeah, posterior portion section. Well, that's two. That makes four altogether. What do you say, Charles?
I said rear.
On his rear. Well, I thought his was a very good answer, glasses. What did you say?
I didn't know he wore glasses.
You didn't know?
No.
Well, I didn't either.
So I said skateboard.
Terrific.
Terrible, isn't it?
No, not bad. Rich, you're up.
If he's that paranoid, you see, wearing them on the glasses would be good.
Yes.
But not when he took a shower, right?
Oh, really?
Well, you don't wear his glasses in the shower, do you?
They get steamy.
They get steamy?
Of course.
What do you wear in the shower?
He had these rearview mirrors put on his body.
On his body.
No one ever snuck up on him.
Oh, I see. Glued him right there.
Immoral, then.
Glasses is the answer that Roger's looking for, Betty.
Now, this is not a good answer, but there's a reason for it, you see.
What?
Because when I first started to do this show, when it was Match Game Aught 73...
Yes.
The only two answers anybody ever gave were bra and bed.
Right.
And I figured he wouldn't have them put on his bra, so I had him put on his bed.
I see.
And it was wrong.
So, in round one, scores 2-0 favor of Terry Casey. We go to round two and ask you to make a selection.
A, please.
A it is for Terry. All right, my dear.
Okay.
Two people
and
do not
matched.
Play. Brett and Charles do not play. They lay out. Everybody else plays. And here it is.
Okay.
Dumb Dora was so dumb.
How dumb was she?
I'm glad you asked. She brought a blank to the stock market. That's how dumb Dora is.
Oh, I just
She brought a blank to the stock market. You're finished. Dumb Dora was so dumb she brought a blank to the stock market. All right.
Oh, I know.
Okay.
Put up the slide and away we go. And we come to Terry Casey. Terry Dumdoro was so dumb, she brought a blank to the stock market.
Okay.
You're thinking about it.
I'd say a cow.
You'd say a cow. Yeah, with the stockyards, where they go to slaughter cows and bulls and heifers and all whatever they do there, steers.
I thought that. Isn't it too bad I wasn't blind?
That is too bad. She said you brought an animal, a cow, to
them. Yes, and I should have said, but I didn't, but I said pig.
You said pig? You said pig.
Not that.
Oh, really?
Okay.
You're up. The answer she's looking for is a cow.
You're going to love this. You're going to love this, Terry. I said a bull.
Well, how about a bull and a cow?
A cow? Sure.
Yeah, that's one for you, Terry. You're up to three. Okay. Dumdoro was so dumb she brought a blank to the stock market. She says a cow.
I didn't work on the stock market. I worked on the market, so I thought she was so dumb she brought a shopping cart.
A cart? Oh, the market.
Yeah.
A blank to the stock market. Okay. And you, Betty?
I almost said bra, because if it wasn't better, it was bra. But I didn't. I said market basket.
All right, different idea there. So, Terry, you picked up one more, and now when we come back from this message, Roger, you're going to have to match three to stay in a game, four to win, and right now we've got this for you. All right, Roger, are you ready for it?
I'm ready.
Remember, three to tie, four to win. Here we go. Everybody plays, right?
Well,
Tarzan said.
Oh, we're here.
Never again Tarzan let Hippie stay in treehouse. Him smoke my blank.
Sure. Sure he did, I know.
Okay. You ready, pale face?
I finished.
You ready?
I finished all finished.
Okay. Now we're calling on Roger Young. Tarzan said, never again Tarzan let Hippie stay in treehouse. Him smoke my...
vine.
Vine. You, what you say?
I've never smoked vine, but,
The answer is grass.
You drink vine.
I'll get you.
And now we go to Brett.
Let's come over, Elaine.
I don't know.
Well, what did Tarzan have on his floor?
On his floor?
Mm-hmm.
Whoops. Well, I don't know.
A rug.
Oh, he had a rug on his floor?
Yes, and it was made of grass.
Grass. Isn't that interesting? A grass rug.
Grass.
Yes, of course. He wove it himself. And you, sir? What do you say?
Fernando.
Roger and I have a relationship isn't very bad since yesterday anyway, but if you take pieces of eight grass and weave it together, you get a vine.
A vine. There's one. Okay. We got three celebrities to go, and you got to match two of them to achieve a tie. If you match everybody in the bottom row, you win the game. Here we are, Elaine.
Ask me how I am.
How are you, Elaine?
Vine.
Aww. You're Vine. That's true, Rod.
Now read the question.
Tarzan said, never again Tarzan let Hippie stay in treehouse. Him smoke my vine, according to Roger.
You smoke my Hollywood and vine.
Yeah. Hollywood and vine. Tie score.
Well, he's funny.
Now, if the swinger down at the end gives you a swinging vine, you win the game. If she doesn't, we go to a tiebreaker.
But what else is Tarzan noted for?
Jane.
No.
Tarzan is noted for wearing a bikini-type garment.
A loincloth.
A loincloth. Oh.
But that was only a cover-up. He smoked his vine.
Oh! Roger, you won the game. Come on down. Congratulations. Stand by for a moment or so. We're going to say goodbye to Terry Casey. It was a pleasure to meet you, dear sweet lady.
Thank you.
We've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being here on Match Game 75. Terry Casey, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye. Here it is. Now, you've been through this before. You know how it goes. Step down stage here, Roger, and let's have a go at it. Here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. clip blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. You match the next one, you get $250, and the bottom one gives you $100. Whom do you call on for a little assist?
Brett.
What about clipboard?
Clipboard. One.
Richard.
Richard?
Where I live, a clip joint.
Clip joint.
Charles.
Charles.
Clip.
Clop. And Merry Christmas to everyone.
Clip clop. What the heck is the clip clop now?
I love him.
My
love
new
him.
Kitty show.
Clip clop. Oh, that's right, Adam.
Clip-clop, it's got to be there.
Okay, clip-clop, you got clip-clop, clip-joint, and clip-board. Do you want one of those?
It's clip-clop.
I'll go with Richard with clip-joint.
Clip-joint is one we want. Okay. Let's find out what a clip-joint is. Shall we do that? Let's reveal the $100 response.
Yeah!
Clip-clop. Try and keep your hands off me, Roger.
Are you lucky I didn't have the blue outfit on
Is
today?
This your husband? Yeah. No. Okay, what are we looking for? We're looking for clip joint, right? Well, come on, I'll find you a clip joint. No. Now, let's look at the $250 response. Clip joint, congratulations, you got it. Who gave you that one? Richard did. There you go. Now, what do you say for the big one? Bored? If you're bored, get out. Let's see. Well, may we see a slide at Earl? Born, yeah. Well, Roger, what this means, you won the $250, means you play for 10 times that amount or $2,500. Now, to collect, remember, you got to match one of them head-to-head. Which one will it be?
This time I'll try Richard.
You're going to try Richard. All right, you face me. I'll get the $2,500 question. And here we go, Richard. Blank. Prize. P-R-I-Z-E. Blank prize. Blank prize. Are you finished, Richard? Yes, you are. All right. Now we need your response, Roger. One you think will match his. What do you say to that? Blank prize.
Booby prize.
Booby prize? You say booby prize? Okay. You wear the hat. He says booby prize will match you, Richard. What do you say to that?
I thought exactly the opposite. The first prize.
First prize. First prize. Okay. Well, now, Roger, you got the $950, and you're going to meet another player later, but right now we're going to meet this message of interest to all of you, so pay attention. Now, we are ready to play another game, and we very happily present to you Leslie Pollack. How are you, my dear? You know Roger, don't you? Now, Leslie, we'd like to find out a little bit about you.
Okay, I have a little boy, he's 3 years old.
Yeah?
And when he heard I was going to be on television, he looked at me and he looked at the TV and he said, "You're too big to be on television." And
you hit him in the mouth?
No.
No.
I'm an artist and I have a needlepoint design and manufacturing company of my own.
No kidding. I do needlepoint.
Do you?
Yeah, I do. I fly a lot and it's very relaxing.
I
and
heard
it's
that
very.
You did.
And you design yourself too.
I design
That's the
them.
Real challenge, isn't it? Yes.
Yes. Well,
have you
Julia
got
Giles
What's
is
that?
Going to be with us next week.
I beg your pardon?
Julia Giles.
Yes, we'll get her, too. Well, good luck to you, Leslie. Let's begin, shall we? We ask you to make a selection here.
B.
B it is. Here we go. Everybody plays. New game.
B.
At the clock shop, Marvin said to the clerk, "This cuckoo clock you sold me has a sick bird. It came out on the hour, but instead of going cuckoo, it blanked." No.
I'm finished.
Yeah?
Yeah?
Okay.
Sick buck. No. All right.
It's
Did you listen to all that, Leslie? Did you hear it all? I'll repeat it for you in a moment or so. All right.
Oh.
Yes. Go ahead, Charles. Put something in the... There we go. Okay, we come to Leslie Pollack. At the clock shop, Marvin said to the clerk, "This cuckoo clock you sold me has a sick bird. It came out on the hour, but instead of going cuckoo, it blinked."
Barfed.
It barfed.
Did you hear what your mother said, little boy?
Okay. What do you say, Bill?
I say that I match. If you'll permit, burped.
Burped? Burping and barfing are two different things. And I don't want to go into any details about either one now. No, Brett, you're up, my dear.
Gene doesn't like barfing jokes. I said belch.
Belch. Okay. Charles.
I was influenced by my south of the border outfit.
Yes.
And I said had the runs.
This cuckoo clock you sold me has a sick bird. It came out on the hour, but instead of going cuckoo, it barfed, according to her.
Woo. Well, I was going to write something else, but the committee suggested I didn't, so I wrote caught a worm.
Caught a worm.
That was a very enterprising bird.
It was
caught
an old,
worm.
Old wormy piece of wood cloth.
Yes.
That's from the
what is that, Richard?
Frew up.
Ah, frew up.
There's one for you, Leslie, and you, my dear.
He said. He said to the clock clerk, "The cuckoo can't cuckoo." He came out of the clock and croaked.
Came out of the clock and cuckoo can't cuckoo. Came out of the clock and croaked. Okay.
Doo-da.
Doo-da. Doo-da.
Doo-doo.
Where are we here? One to nothing. And we go to you, Roger. This is your first round question. Listen carefully.
These are getting tricky.
Jonah said, "I've got a television set here inside the whale, but I don't watch it much because the only program I get is blank."
Huh, that's a stumper.
Hello? Hello? Jonah, inside the whale. Everybody get the idea. Got the picture.
I got it.
Okay.
I got it, sweetheart. I'm all finished. I'm sitting here ready to go.
All right.
But I wish I could stop inhaling this.
Good. Jonah and the whale, Betty.
I know it. What's the matter with you, Betty?
I don't know. I wish I were home. I can't even spell. I'm going to sit out this one. I'm really going to sit
it's
out
not allowed.
This one. Yes, I can if I don't.
That's very good. You came up with a good one. All right. Here we go, Roger. Jonah said, "I've got...
under my skin."
"Why are you shrinking from me? I have a television set inside this whale, but I don't watch it much because the only program I get is
Flipper."
Flipper. Okay. He said Flipper, which is good. It pertains to the sea. What do you say?
Well, this pertains to seeing also.
Yeah, match game. Makes you sick. All right, Brett, what do you say?
I say...
You said match game, too.
Yeah.
Okay, Charles.
Again influenced by my south of the border outfit.
Yes.
I said to my friend's program, Hedison's, "A Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea."
Voyage to the Bottom of the Sea, pertains to the sea. He said Flipper, that's the answer he's looking for. Elaine, show us yours, if you would, please.
I was going to say Jacques Cousteau, but I couldn't spell it, so I figured Sea Hunt.
Sea Hunt, another sea time thing. Richard?
I could spell Sea Hunt, so I said Jacques Cousteau.
Jack Cousteau. All right. So at the end of round one, scores 1-0 favor of Leslie, and now we've got this message for you. Here we are, coming out on three. There's three, and there you are. And you are too. 1-0, and we'll see you next time, whenever that is. I don't know when that is. You know when that is?
When is that?
The afternoon just flew.
What time is it?
Time flies.
It does.
All right, we'll see you around here. What do we got? 10 seconds. Oh, well, we can kill that in a half hour, can't we?
Right.
Okay, we'll see you around next time. G-Way, that's it. Bye-bye.
This program was edited for broadcast.
Thank you.